I was always told that what does not kill you makes you stronger. Yet nowhere in that equation was I told about awareness. I only understood that something was happening. Waking up after a long slumber, one is raw and unbalanced. Every little thing pushes or pulls one into oblivion. Polarities, black and white, extremes. I acquired the camera to shoot landscapes, thinking that if I wanted to shoot people, I'd buy a gun. After all, hell is other people. It is like an addiction. I yearn for the quietness of solitude and to be absorbed by the nothingness that surrounds. I often feel fragmented, yet if I chip away at the fragments and reassemble them, can I ever arrive at a truly holistic nirvana? When one is not awake, the same defense mechanisms go unchecked. Looking back, I always seem defensive, and yet loaded up with other people's issues. It still frustrates, yet not to the same levels. What I've learned is that people seek safety and security in consumerism, religion, or both. Everything is projected at those around them, attack being the only way of keeping the illusion alive. If I am pointing the finger outwards, I can create enough space to completely avoid looking within. Never told in our childhood to mind the gap. This abyss pulls us from the clutches of corporate greed, yet eventually we are sucked right back into the machine. The promise of a better tomorrow comes in the form of a packaged commodity that binds us to conformity, stagnation, and misery. Everything seems to be in the process. We create an illusion to make life more palatable, yet when the taste is gone, we feel failure. And yet that feeling of failure contains answers. We live in an oversaturated world where the images are vivid and striking. Yet when I look at life or try to capture it, the colours are washed by grey and the image blurred. The nearest I can get to the vivid strikingness is through process in post-production. So is it in the limitations of the camera or my mind that things are seen as they are? Is it limitation, my own mechanism, or have I just been sold the illusion? If I look at my mother, who is ill right now, I am sad. Is it then that I try and capture the feelings how I'd feel if she was dead? There seems to be no difference in the level of sadness of her life or death. Even when I accept what is going on without looking for meaning, I find others are not accepting of my situation. This then moves me toward their opinion and dilutes my own. If I am looking at it in a cinematic sense, it is all very real. And yet there appears the threshold of something far more deeper within me. I cannot walk over that threshold, it seems. I travel full circle. I end and begin at a threshold. I never enter the house. It remains a mystery. What is this sphere? It is only in accepting myself that I can cope in a corrupt world and try to make some sense of the hopeless loss. Regrets make me sullen. Was it all in vain? The road can be wherever I want it. I can record life and take it as raw footage. It is in the process that I can colour it, use filters, tint, lighten, or darken it. I can make life the way I want it. I can bring focus, depth, and clarity. I may even, in the Archimedean sense, find a place to stand and move the world. That is if I have not already found it. Naivety, I thought all I had to do was point and shoot. It still just may be that we are all damaged beyond our means to ever fully recover ourselves, or even start from a point of integration. Pain at times reminds me of the air slowly escaping from a balloon, yet it is me that is controlling the loss. Sometimes things are presented to us so that we may gain more understanding of ourselves. If I allude to nothing, nothing alludes to me. If I attempt to subjugate the loss and misery, things stay the same. It is only when it appears in my consciousness that I have the option of change. Yet this change may only ever be my creative adjustment.